Hello everyone, I'm Small Potato and this is
Average Potato.
Welcome to our podcast, Potato Talk,
where we talk about the lives of the average potatoes. In today's topic, we'll be talking about the new E129, free money given by government. Is it?
Yeah, free money given by government. Correct.
So let's jump into the free money given by the government. Okay. Yeah.
So recently, the government, as everyone has known, the government is launched this free 129. But they say for average Malaysian. Mm. So average potato, since you are average, right?
Yeah. Okay. Why you keep laughing? Podcast serious. Serious content. Okay, money serious.
We need to record. Okay, records you just.
Why?
You just remove.
Remove my this one? Never mind lah, no big deal lah.
Okay. So average potato, since you are average potato, so who are the average Malaysians?
So the average Malaysian who has attained the age of 18 and above.
Okay.
And who earns less than 100,000 ringgit annual income can get 30 ringgit free e-wallet money, electronic money from the government. Okay. So finance minister want you to spend money by giving you some money.
But I got question. This 100,000 lesser the 100,000, right? Is it really average people earning that? Or
I think the average Malaysian makes about 2,500 to 3,000 ringgit Malaysia. So 1 month 3,000, 12 months is 60,000. So a lot of people they should be able to get lah. Unless you are making more than 100,000, sorry, you're not eligible. But what is 30 ringgit to you if you're making more than 100,000 ringgit?
But other than that, what is the criteria?
Of course, since it's electronic, you have to have some electronics to start with lah. So if you have a handphone, first, before you can get, you must get a handphone. Because if you don't have handphone, so the government is cheating, they're not giving you money, they're asking you to buy a handphone first. So for those people with no handphone, you have to buy a handphone first.
And I will say the handphone is not some average handphone also, because need to have some feature for you to do your e-wallet.
Right? Yeah, your handphone must have internet, so you probably have to go and get data.
If not, you have to find somewhere with Wi-Fi.
Actually, no, you have to have data, Wi-Fi no use, because if you spend your e-wallet, you cannot like connect to Wi-Fi at the shop,
yeah, true,
and then you spend. So the government actually, they are slamming you two times. First, you have to buy the phone, which the cheapest average good phone, it probably cost 1,000 ringgit. Then you have to subscribe to a data plan, like whatever, Nexis, Digi, Cellcom. And then there, they will slap you about 15 ringgit every month, average fee to use your data. So if you got Wi-Fi, unless the shop got Wi-Fi for you to scan your QR code, to make payment, then you're actually being screwed by the government twice. Buy a handphone and apply for data, so they can collect more taxes from the handphone seller and also collect more taxes from the telco providers.
So we can kind of say, like, before we think ahead, the government actually think 3 steps
ahead. Yeah, the government is not really giving you 30 ringgit. The 30 ringgit they give you, they collect a lot more in taxes.
Yeah,
you are correct.
Okay, so like that, if you're average potato, then are you actually eligible for it?
This 30 ringgit is actually an infringement to my privacy. So far, I'm using Grab, and I'm also using Touch and Go. I don't use Boost. I don't know why, because Boost cannot call taxi. Okay, so I don't use Boost.
Touch and Go can call taxi.
Touch and Go can call taxi. There's a few other company in Touch and Go.
Okay.
So for me, I feel that if you want to get this 30 ringgit, the first thing you have to sacrifice is your privacy. Because you have to upgrade your wallet and you have to put your IC there. And there's the regulation on this IC, I feel, is not strict enough, because you never pangkah your IC for what purposes.
Yep, true.
So every time you put your IC there, the company that collect your data, they are so powerful. They know your face, your home address, your date of birth.
Actually, this Touch and Go e-wallet, I also feel a bit scary, because like when I first subscribed to it, then they asked me to verify. After they verify straight away, of course I need to put my IC everything in. Then that day when I was trying to get that 30 ringgit, straight away my IC is in there already.
Your IC in the system.
Yeah, before I even
Upload. They have your IC before you upload.
They have my IC because last time I verified. So I thought that last time I verified, then maybe they will like, you know, dispose it lah. But
so it's like double confirm lah, is it?
But now it's like straight away I want to click. I want to claim this one. Then straight away my IC is at the background. So I feel like what you say is true lah.
You don't feel so safe lah. So actually, the 30 ringgit is actually a form of control. You know, it's like. I feel it's like a surveillance system. What do you think?
I think it's quite scary also. Actually, I didn't think of it. I thought it's like free money. Yay!
not free money.
Until now you mentioned about this infringement, then I'm also quite scared because I also don't want it to be like China like that. You know, you got the social credit or don't know what later. Not to say I'm a bad person, okay? I throw rubbish in the rubbish bin one. But it's just that I'm very scared later. I don't know what they do.
This thing I feel like is a form of surveillance. Well, they can track where you spend your money. It's not really tracking how much you spend or what you buy. It's tracking where the person is most of the time. If let's say actually it's a form of verifying that you were at some place at some time. But moving forward, we have to embrace this thing you know, because we got no choice ma, unless you still use cash, right? And I feel this product is actually very unfair for the elderly generation. Because the people who are the elderly, they probably are not very familiar with the phone. You know, and they probably do not trust the electronics so much. So actually it comes down to it, I think very very few people can make use of this E29 30 ringgit.
As in like out of the age, out of that age band, I think. Because like I would say elderly also, when it comes to internet banking, it's such a necessity, but they are also struggling with it already.
And then let's talk about this 30 ringgit lah. What do you think people can really make use of this 30 ringgit now? You know, I think this 30 ringgit is the personally like 30 ringgit can be spent pretty fast. Let's say you can pay 30 ringgit to eat mixed economy rice. Okay, let's say some shop accepts 30 ringgit mixed economy. But you see mixed economy rice, how much now you eat mixed economy rice?
I think if I order like just one drumstick, one fried egg and one veggie, about 9 ringgit.
9 to 10 let's put it 10 lah, 10 lah. So it's actually the government belanja you makan zafan 3 times lah, I would say.
But if you're kids
If kids then one time gone already lah, GG liao. But beyond this this give up of 450 million budget by the government, the 30 ringgit to me doesn't really solve a lot of our normal people's problem. Our problem is not really that we really need 30 ringgit. I feel like it's another waste of money. Imagine the amount of people you need to hire to process this system, you know. Like the companies, the government has to hire people to do filing, to verify who is eligible, who is not eligible. The amount of paperwork and admin needed to do, it will cost more than the 30 ringgit, you know.
Correct.
You know, the your data store in the server, how you maintain it. I mean, want to give more lah, you know.
Correct.
The cost of maintaining the information and administration is much more than 30 ringgit per person. That's what I feel. Of course, I don't have the exact figure.
But I think like Malaysians overall, I don't know lah, but I would say average potatoes like me, small potato, I would say like, God take first lah, right?
I know you cheesecake probably try to get all three.
Average also take first lah, right?
Open three account, want to put at the same time get 90 ringgit.
My thing is still pending process.
So actually, those people who think they are smart, they go and open three accounts, apply three at the same time, but all three will be pending at the same time, correct?
Pending approval. They all reject.
Make sure you got no duplicate. So to make sure you got no duplicate, they spend more money to make sure you don't duplicate the three times the receiver of the
base of resources.
Okay. So until here, so we have focused on the issue. I think personally, this is just my thoughts. I think the government should encourage e-wallet, but before that, we have to you know, make sure the privacy issue that is solved first, because there's not much debate going online about our privacy and how things are, how secure the payments are.
Yeah.
You see, so most of the payment that you can top up easily from through your bank account or your credit card. You can use your fingerprint or you can use your PIN code to make payment. So I feel a lot of things are not that secure yet lah. And these licenses, these e-wallet licenses are. They are like semi-bank regulated lah, by Bank Negara.
Yeah.
Do you feel that the public is aware of the regulation for this?
I don't think so. Yeah. And then, like you say, infringement is an issue.
Mm.
It's just like, for example, nowadays we also have the face recognition thing. Then everything also face recognition. Recently, Europe also just came out with a new regulation. For 5 years, they have to ban the face recognition so that the government can work on like securing the thing first.
Make sure you're safe first.
So I think we shouldn't also jump on the bandwagon lah.
So my advice to you if you haven't registered this 30 ringgit, you wait for the problem to arise first. Make sure everything safe. Then only you get your. But actually it's stupid lah, because they make sure you spend the money by 15th of March .
I didn't read.
Yeah, they only give you like 60 days to spend the money, you know.
Oh, okay. So I think by the time they approve it's already 14th of March.
Yeah. No, I don't think so lah. Maybe. Yeah. Okay, what else you want to say? Our podcast has really gone beyond 10 minutes. So as you know, beyond 10 minutes we can have a we will try to make more than 10 minutes so we can have 2 advertisements. It's YouTube now. You can put 2 advertisements for a video above 10 minutes. So thank you for watching for more than 10 minutes.
Why you didn't ask me what I'm going to spend the 30 minutes?
Oh yeah, sorry. How are you? I thought you said mixed rice already.
No.
Okay. What you want to buy with 30 ringgit?
I think I will only take and pay toll.
Pay toll lah.
Yeah, and pay toll all the way. Because after you mentioned about the infringement, a bit scared lah. Okay lah, never mind lah, just pay toll lah.
But they also know where you go, which toll you use .
Oh, but pass already.
Not there anymore.
Yeah, just on the way, by the way.
If you go to like DIY or the shop that you spend also, you also leave the shop . Oh, but they know you're always in that area.
Yeah. I don't want them to know I'm always at there.
Let's say you're always at Cheras.
At least, let's say I pass by the Mutiara Damansara toll, right?
You pass it.
I pass already, I can go Kepong Sungai Buloh.
Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye.
Yeah.
Okay, so question for you. Where will you spend your 30 ringgit? You know, leave a comment in the box below.
And do you feel that your security has been infringed?
Yeah. Okay. So before you wrap up, I'm Mr. Potato. I average potato.
I'm small potato.
Okay. If you like this video, please subscribe and share this video. If you hate this video, give me a thumbs down. I appreciate your thumbs down.
Hey, wait. I also uploaded a Touch and Go Reload e-wallet on my own channel.
Okay.
So we will put a link below.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mousy Ting
Mousy Ting is the channel, but I'm small potato.
Okay, Mousy Ting's channel, okay?
Yeah, I'm Mousy Ting's narrator only.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Bye. How to offer? Oh, okay.